What's up, guys? It's TechnoViking23 coming to you today with a successful solo against the Collectors on Bronze on Mass Effect 3 multiplayer. For this run today, we're going to be using the human female Sentinel, which is one of the base characters you get right at the start of the game. Going to be using Tech Armor, Warp, and Throw as our main powers here. Also using the M8 Avenger Assault Rifle and the M92 Mantis Sniper Rifle, which are both opening level weapons you will get as soon as you start the multiplayer. So this is basically a full beginner character run here, even though we are doing the Collectors and we do manage to solo them. I cannot tell you guys how thrilled I was when I finally got to the very end of this and realized I was going to make Extraction. Very happy, very exciting. This was my 10th Bronze solo completed, and I kind of made a little rule with myself that I could not go up to Silver and try soloing Silver until I was able to beat these darn Collectors on Bronze. As I've said many times, this is the hardest faction for me to play against on this game. They just have so many enemies who just take you down so fast and make your life miserable. When you're playing the Collectors, it's like you never really feel like you can take a breather. They're constantly pushing you all over the map, constantly chasing you around, whether it's the Abominations or the Seeker Swarms or the Scions with their, you know, insta-death ray. It just seems like the Collectors are always right in your face, and they don't give you a minute to kind of collect your thoughts or form your strategy. It's like you just kind of have to go on a whim and just run with it and just hope that you get it right. And we're on Firebase Giant map, which is a pretty good solo map here because it does give you a lot of cover spots, a lot of areas you can kite enemies through. Again, it just depends what you get on those objective waves on wave 3. Wave 6 and wave 10. You will see that things do get very hairy on this run on wave 6 and wave 10. I believe wave 10, it stuck me with an objective recovery. And of course, there were two Scions right in the middle of the freaking map where they have full line of sight on me and they're able to just gun me down the whole time. So it got a little touch and go there, but it was able to finally get that done. At the end of it, I said, you know what, it's wave 10. And I've failed this so many times already. I'm just going to go for it and see what happens. And I actually walk by two Scions carrying the objective literally like 5 feet away and somehow slip past them and was able to get the objective finish. But got really hairy. I had enough metagel left, though. I figured I could pull it off either way if I had to take a death there even to get it done. But this took some time. I think I spent about almost 4 hours just trying to get a Collector solo. Done. I made it to wave 10 and 11 so many times and died in so many frustrating ways at the end, whether it was a bad objective wave that I got screwed with, or just bad luck, or just the Collectors, you know, being jerks. they are kind of jerks in this game, especially the Praetorians. They'll sneak around the map and sneak up on you. You won't even notice. And just overall, like I said, they've got so many different enemies that can do so much damage to you. And with the Abominations and the Seeker Swarms constantly coming after you, you feel like you're just on the run. You can't get a breather. And it's hard to take cover in spots and get a few minutes to kind of whittle the enemies down because you're always being swarmed with something. So it was very difficult, but we got it done. So I just wanted to show you guys it can be done. You can solo Collectors even using the base level character that you get right when you start the game. You don't need a very powerful character to do it. You just have to kind of be able to play well and play within yourself. And like I said, at the end of it, I just said, you know what, screw it, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to try to make it happen. And we managed to do it. So there's hope for everybody. If I can solo the Collectors, I'm sure everybody else can too. But so this was kind of my big accomplishment for the Bronze tier. So we got all 10 of our Bronze solos finished. Now we have 5 Silver solos, 2 Gold solos, and or 1 Platinum solo. So I'm probably going to wind up doing the 5 Silver and the 2 gold, because Platinum, I have not even... I've tried like one game of Platinum the entire time I've owned Mass Effect 3, and it was brutal. So, we'll see what happens. But I got to move up to Silver now. I'm going to have to kind of sit down and look at some characters I have and decide what I'm going to do for strategy with those, because Silver is a whole new ballgame versus Bronze. Silver really just takes the difficulty level up really high. You get a lot more bosses, especially in the last couple waves of the game. You're going to get almost double, triple the number of bosses you do in Bronze. So it's much, much harder. And one of my main problems here is that I only have 2 missiles unlocked. So that's only like 2 bosses I can kill instantly with those missiles if I get lucky or get them in an area that's really close together. And I've only got 3 ops packs, which means I can only recharge my shields and health mid-wave 3 times. I'm having to go through those using those on bronze, so it's going to be even more difficult on silver when I don't have that equipment capacity yet. And one thing, that's another thing that I was doing with these solos, guys, is if you watch a lot of other solo channels or people that do solos on this game, a lot of the times they're running with full equipment unlocked. And when I say that is the D-pad, which you have the four things on the left. You've got your missiles, you've got your thermal packs, you've got your ops packs, and you've got your metagel. You start off only being able to carry two of each of those when you first start the game. You get unlocks through opening packs from the store. You can get them in recruit packs, veteran packs, specter packs, premium specter packs. But most of the time, they're not going to come if you don't buy those rare packs like the premium specter packs. So it can be very difficult to get that equipment unlocked. You can see I do have 5 thermal clip pack capacity and 4 metagel, but I still am stuck with 3 ops packs and 2 missiles. And a lot of people who solo the higher difficulty, the gold, they solo the platinum, they're using 6 missiles, or they might even be using armored compartments, which is a gear slot that actually gives you, allows you to carry up between 1 and 3, or you can go up to 9 missiles total. And a lot of people, when they solo gold and platinum, have that full complement of missiles. And again, I don't have that equipment yet, so it's going to be kind of difficult to try to do the solos on silver without some of that equipment. So to make up for this, I'm basically going to kind of have a free-for-all when I do silver. I'm going to use just whatever characters and whatever weapons I have. The point of doing the bronze solos was mainly as sort of a beginner guide, somewhat to solos and to the game, because I wanted to show you guys you can use some of the base level characters in this game and you can solo with them pretty well, which means they're going to do very well for you also in a group content, because obviously soloing in this game is not necessary. It's just there's one achievement in the game out of like a ton that you can do for solo. So I really wanted to kind of do that to show you guys a way to kind of practice with yourself. You know, if you want to really work on your skills and learn how to get the most out of your character, soloing is a great way to do that. And wanted to show you guys that you could use those beginner characters, the ones that you get right out of the box when you first start the Mass Effect multiplayer. Some of you guys who already have the game and are veterans probably have all this other stuff unlocked, but I know there's a lot of new players coming into Mass Effect 3 now, which is great. It's a really great experience. It's a great game. And this is more aimed to kind of show them that, yes, you can still play at a decent level and you can still solo all of the enemies. We did Cerberus, we did Reapers, we did Geth, and we did Collectors. So we soloed all the enemy groups on the bronze level with the base level characters, the common, and even a couple uncommon characters you get. So it is doable. It is possible. So just wanted to do that. But when we move up to silver, like I said, difficulty does go up quite a bit. So I'm going to be using some more powerful characters that I have that I've unlocked that are uncommon characters, rare characters that I've gotten from some higher level packs like the reserve pack, which costs 100,000 credits. So we'll be going over that. And I decided what I'm going to do when I do the silver runs is I know a lot of people wanted to know what builds I was using on these bronze solos. So I actually am going to be making a video after this. I'm going to go through each character, show you guys what build I was using on those characters, and I'll post that after this one. But I think for the silver one, what I'll do is I'll do the same thing here. I'll do the gameplay, do a little voiceover at the beginning of the gameplay, and then at the very end of the gameplay, I'll tack on a little video at the end showing the build of the character, the weapons used, things like that. Talk about that a little bit, so I can give you guys some pointers there. So, but that's pretty much it. I'm just really excited to finally get a collector solo finished. I was starting to think they were just going to be trolling me forever, that they would never, I would never be able to do it, but finally was able to stick it out. And I was tempted at times to go use more powerful characters, but I was like, no, you know, the whole goal of this is to show that you can do it using, you know, one of the base level characters. So we managed to do it. So I hope you guys enjoyed the gameplay, enjoyed the commentary. I hope you guys have enjoyed the first little bit of this solo series with the bronze solos. We're going to be moving up to silver, and I hope you guys will join me for that and watch those videos as well. As usual, guys, if you have any questions about anything you saw here, please feel free to leave a comment below. Whether it's anything with the multiplayer, Mass Effect in general. If you guys have any of your own build tips and guides, your own solo tips, feel free to leave those as well. And again, hope you guys are having a great day. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again next time.
Thank you. shut up and sit down.